Welcome back to Maths class. So this is the class for the new chapters I'm going to teach you. I'm so happy. After a long days, I want to teach you. So already we completed the four chapters. First two, third, and fourth chapter we have some incomplete. Now coming to the chapter number 5, the name of arithmetic progression. Arithmetic progression. So first, I want to give you the short note for that importance of this topic. So arithmetic progression is a very important topic for you. It will continue for your 11th standard and as well as 12th and then your higher studies also. And it is a very basic thing for your number system. Already you studied the real numbers, you know. So based on the number system, it will be continue for you. Okay. So first, I want to give you that one small intro for this. For this unit, you have a 4 exercises. So the first exercise is very easiest exercise. How to frame the arithmetic progression and what are the terms are there. And the second exercise, it is arithmetic sequence nth term. Then third exercise is sum of the n terms. And fourth exercise is your optional. Okay, it's good. Let us come to our class. So arithmetic sequence, and before that, I want to tell you what is sequence. Sequence. So already you know very well about this word in your routine life. Okay, it is a sequence wise, which means a sequence is the arrangement of a real number in some specific order. Some specific order. So what is the arrangement of? For example, I'm giving you the listed of odd numbers. So what are the odd numbers? 1, 3, 5, 7, it's moving. Suppose we have a limitation. So listed the numbers of listed of odd numbers less than 10. So less than 10 means what? We come 1 to 9. Okay. So for that, we have some specific order in the arrangement of real numbers. It is mentioned by sequence. Okay. And sequence, we have one more name, that is progression. Progression. Okay. So basically, sequence, you have two types. So the first one is arithmetic sequence. It is based upon your addition. And second one is geometric sequence. Actually, this is not in your portion. Geometric sequence. This is not in your syllabus. You are going to study in your 11th syllabus. Okay. Yeah, fine. Now coming to the arithmetic sequence. So arithmetic sequence is very simple. We want to I want to give you one sequence. Okay, and before that sequence, mean you know what is the sequence? A sequence is a listed or arrangement of some numbers in specific order. Yes. So for that arithmetic sequence, I give you one sequence: 1, 8, 12, like that. Okay. So do you know this is the sequence? So how many terms are available? The first term is 4, second term is 8, and third term is 12, and moving on. Okay, and one more thing you want to know about this arithmetic sequence also, you have two types. One is fine and AP. Arithmetic sequence is commonly we are going to mention by AP, the short form. Arithmetic progression is denoted by AP. Okay, so arithmetic progression AP have two types. The first one is fine and AP, and second one is infinite AP. Infinite AP. So for based on that, see, so you have a sequence 4, 8, 12, it is moving. So that is the what kind of AP? Infinite AP, because we don't know the last term. Okay. Suppose one, I give you one more question, one more sequence like that. Okay. See, you have the numbers 1, 5, 9, up to 51. Okay. I have a first number and as well as the last number. First term and last term. So this one is called the finite AP. When the AP have a first and last term, that is finite AP. And then first term only we know, but we don't know that last term, that is infinite AP. Yes, student. Yeah, fine. And take your book page number 95. So if they are giving some examples, consider the following listed of number. Already I told you the listed of numbers is called that. What is that sequence? In some specific order. Yeah. Okay. Now the first question, first one is given 1, 2, 3, 4. It is moving. So that is called the set of natural numbers.
Okay. And second one is given 100, comma 70, comma 40, and you can see. So the sequence 100, comma 70, comma 40, comma 10, it is moving on.
See, listen, student. You have a sequence in the named by the first number, second. I mean, within the comma, we are going to mention. No. So one more number is mentioned by each term or member or element. Anything you have to mention. But maximum we are going to mention by terms only. So this is the first term mentioned by A1. And this is the second term mentioned by A2. And third term, then fourth term, and moving on. Okay.
Yeah, okay, fine.
So for that, do you know what is the difference between that first and second number, second and third number, third and fourth number, and so going on? See, so the first term is 100 though, and second one is 70. So what is the difference of what is happening here? So the after the first term, it is reduced or decreased by 30 each and every number. Okay, so 100 minus 30 is 70. And 70 minus 30 is 40, 40 minus 30 is 10, and so moving on. So for that, what I am going to say is the number 30 is decreased every term of the given sequence. So like that, each any one of the common number is being increased or decreased in the corresponding term, that is called the arithmetic progression. Okay, and one more example also giving this. 3. Minus 3, comma, minus 2, comma, minus 2, 0, it's moving. So here also, minus 3 and minus 2, what is the difference between them? Minus 1, no. It is reduced by, addition, reduced not, addition, because it is integer. So added by minus 1 to get that the sequence. Or otherwise, I'm giving that. The fourth one is 3, comma, 3, comma, 3. So for that sequence, it is different. Why? Because of all the terms are the same values. All the terms are same value. So like that sequence, we are going to mention constant sequence. Constant sequence. Yes, student? Fine. So finally, I'm giving you the definition for AP, arithmetic progression. So arithmetic progression is a listed of numbers which each term is obtained by adding a fixed number or subtracting the fixed number. But one thing is very important, except that the first term we can't do anything. So first term is the first term. So after the first term, we are going to add or subtract or doing something and to get the next consecutive terms. Okay, so that is called AP. So the fixed number, here what is the fixed number? 30 is reduced to. Here what is the fixed number? Minus 1. Here that is no fixed number. So maybe if you want to fixed number, means take 0. Take that 0. So for that, so the fixed number is mentioned by fixed numbers. So that is common difference. Common difference. So listen carefully. So the common difference is that common for all the terms, it is increased or decreased by the fixed number. Okay. So for that, I have one formula, common difference, which is denoted by the small letter D equal to A2 minus A1. A2 minus A1. And otherwise A3 minus A2, otherwise A4 minus A3, and so moving on. Why? Because of already I told you what is AB? The fixed number want to increase or reduce by the fixed number for each and every term. So like D equal to A2 minus A1, A3 minus A2, A4 minus A3. For all the values it will come equal only. Suppose the numbers are not equal coming. What we do? See, for example, 5 comma 15 comma 11 comma 9 comma 7. So it's moving on. So this is one sequence. I'm taking the common difference of first two terms. A2 minus A1, second term minus first term, 11 minus 15, which is equal to minus 4. But, and then third term minus second term, D equal to third term is 9, minus 11, which is equal to what will come? Minus 2. And then next year, again also I am going to mention by A4 minus A3, A4
7 and A3 is 9. So it will become minus 1. See here, for this case, the first common difference is not equal to from the second two cases. So that is, this sequence is not common AP. Have you got it, children?
Yeah, okay.
And the next, in the first exercise already I told you, it is very simple. The common difference is maybe positive or negative or zero. Anything it will come. The fixed number, common difference, no. That's all. See, and next, already I told you, we have two types of AP. One is a finite AP and next one is a infinite AP. Okay, student. Now, fine. Now, I want to give you some questions to practice. The example 1. And before that, I want to recollect your knowledge from the AP. So, what is AP? You know, AP is the arithmetic progression. And one more thing is, what is another name of that? Arithmetic sequence. Okay, so what is the arithmetic sequence? Definition already I told you, and again I remind you, the arithmetic progression is the listed of numbers which each term is obtained by adding a fixed number except that first term. So that is called AP. Okay, fine, sure. So how to verify the given sequence is AP or not mean? We have to take the common difference for the second and first term, third and second term, fourth and third term, like that we want to take. If it is all the difference or it will come equal, means that is AP, otherwise it is not AP. Okay, so example 1, the question is given 3/2, 1/2, -1/2, -3/2. See, so AP 3/2, 1/2, -1/2, -3/2. See, write the first term A and the common difference D. So given this is the AP, already the given question is that they are given, it is AP. So we need to find the first term and as well as common difference. So first term is very simple, already I told you the first term is what is the first term of the sequence that is mentioned by A. The first term is A. Okay, and next term, common difference. What I am going to find? Common difference. So common difference is D equal to, what is the formula? A2 minus A1, or otherwise A3 minus A2, A4 minus A3, whatever you have to take, that is your wish. But one thing is, the first two things is enough. Alright. So A2 minus A1 means 1/2 minus 3/2. 1/2 minus 3/2. So what will come 1/2 minus 3/2? It will come what? The common denominator is 1 minus 3 equal to -2/2. It will come -1. So this is your common difference. So have you understood how to find the first term and then common difference? And you have exercise page number 99, the question number 2, like this model. Question number 2 for this model. So for that question number 2, I give you one question. Listen. So from the question number 2 is all are very simple. First term is not in the first question. Okay. Write the first four term. Okay, and before that, sorry, the question number 3 is good. Yeah. Question number 3 is the same pattern. For the following APs, write the first term and the common difference. You have 4 division. I give you 2 questions. Okay. And remaining you have to write. So the first question is very simple. What is given sequence? 3, 1, -1, -3, it's moving. And the third question is given 1/3, 5/3, 9/3, 13/3 and moving. So what is the given question? For the following AP, we need to find the first term and the common difference. So already we know the first term A is equal to 3. And the common difference, you have a formula, that is A2 minus A1. A2 means A2 represents the second term of the sequence, A1 represents the first term of sequence. So A2 minus A1 means 1 minus 3 which is equal to minus 2. So this is your common difference. That's all very simple questions. Okay. And next is here also the same. The first given sequence is 1/3, 5/3, 9/3, 13/3 and so going. So for that the first term is 1/3. Next, what am I going to do?
The common difference.
So the common difference D is equal to A2 minus A1. So the second term A2 is 5/3 minus A1 is 1/3. So 5/3 minus 1/3, you have a common denominator, so directly you have to subtract it. So 5 minus 1, 4/3. So this is your common difference. Look at the sequence. It is increasing by 4 no in the numerator. So that's all. So have you understood, student, what I am giving you? We want to find the first term and common difference. And next pattern I am going to do. And before that, I want to give you the general form of AP. General form of AP. Take your book, the page number 96. So what is in your classroom you are going to write? The same, the first, write the definition of AP, the page number 95. Write the three lines. And the fixed number is called a common difference and the two lines. So the two is enough. And next, the page number 96, you have a general form of AP.
General form of AP.
So it is very simple. General form mean, already I told you how to produce the AP. We have a first term and we have a common difference. It is moving. I mean, it is increasing. It is obtained by the fixed number. It will be increase or reduce. Okay. So for that, the general form of an AP, each and every term you have a A, A plus B, A plus 2D, A plus 3D. And so going on. Okay, so like that only the terms are going to expand. So in common we have already told you the difference A2 minus A1 which is equal to A3 minus A2 which is equal to A4 minus A3 and so going on. In general, I am giving you the difference D equal to AN minus AN minus 1. So for that whatever you have to take and write, it's not a problem. But commonly we are taking this formula. Common difference D equal to maximum A2 minus A1. It is enough. Yes, student. So the first term of an AP is what? A. First term of AP is A. Second term is A plus D. Why? Because of it is increased by the fixed number D. And third term, it is increased by the again the second time the fixed number, that is A plus D plus D, A plus 2D. And the fourth term, A plus D plus D plus D, 3D. So A plus 3D and so going on like this. So this is your general form of an AP. Have you got it, children? Yes, fine. Now let us go to our exercise problems. Exercise 5.1. It is very easiest exercise in your fifth chapter. Okay, see, it is a statement only. In which of the following situations does the listed of number involved make an AP arbitrary progression and why? See, the first question is given, the taxi fare after the each kilometer when the fare is 15 rupees for the first kilometer and rupees 8 for each additional kilometer. It is very simple. So the taxi fare they are going to announce, the first kilometer you have to pay rupees 15 and next the consecutive one kilometer, it will be the additional kilometer, it will be the cost of 8 rupees. If it is forms an AP, means yes, this is the forms an AP. Why? Because of the concept of AP is obtained by the fixed number for each and every term except the first term. So that's why the first term is 15 rupees and the next term consecutively it is increasing by 8 rupees. So that is constant AP. It is enough. And how to answer this question? Write the question, use the black sheet or black head, your wish. So, and then you have to write the first kilometer fare, EA equal to 15 rupees. And the additional cost is mentioned by D equal to 8 rupees. That's all enough. Okay, and the next question, the amount of air present in the cylinder when a vacuum pump remove 1/4 of air remaining in the cylinder. It is impossible to make a AP. Why? Because of, see, in the vacuum pump, so the air, we can't measure as a fixed. Okay, maybe if you are going to open that, the air will come, we can't measure it. So that one is not common air. And third one is very simple. The cost of a digging a well, for every meter digging, the cost is 150 meter for the first meter. And raises by rupees 50 and the subsequent meter. And the next subsequent means the consecutive, that's all. Okay. So that is also AP. The fourth question comes to you. And before the fourth question, I want to tell you, already you studied the 8th standard, simple interest and as well as compound interest. So simple interest, you know, every year the rate of interest based on this, we have the simple interest, you know, I equal to PNR by 100. P is the principal, N is the number of years, R is the rate of interest, R otherwise PRP by 100. Okay, so like that. So simple interest always it is forms an AP, but compound interest does not forms an AP. Okay, yes students. And the second question I am going to give you. So this is your based on the question example 2. So example 2, which of the following listed of number form an AP? If they form an AP, write the next two terms. And this is the same pattern for you in the question number 2. Okay, so I am giving you the question number 2. The example is another. Okay, the question number 2, they are giving the five divisions. I am going to teach you that easiest and the bond. Like that. So third question I am going to teach. Third question, A equal to 4 and B equal to minus 3. Okay, sorry, example 2, it is based on the question number 4, I tell you later. So the question number 2, I am going to teach you now. The question number 2, you have 5 questions, and I am going to teach you the first, as a third and fourth question. Third question is, given A equal to 4, B equal to minus 3, and the fifth question is, A is equal to given minus 1.25, then common difference is minus 0.25. Yes, student, yes. Fine. Students, listen. What is the given question asking? Write the first four terms of an AP when the first term and common difference is given. It is very simple, student. So first you have to mention the first four terms of AP. Four terms of an AP. What are they, you know? Yeah. So the first term is A, second term is A plus B, third term is A plus 2D, and fourth term is A plus 3D. It's so going on. Okay, so first term already you know that is 4, then A equal to 4, then A plus B equal to what is that? A is 4 plus minus 3. Okay, 4 minus 3 is equal to 1. Yes, student. And the third term, A plus 2D, which is equal to mentioned by Yogesh, A1 equal to A2 equal to A3 equal to Yogesh, otherwise, right, directly it's not a problem. So A plus 2D is A, the value of A is 4. Plus 2 into minus 3. So 4 plus into minus minus 2, 3 is 6. So 4 minus 6 equal to minus 2. Yes? And the fourth term, A4 which is equal to D. A plus 3D. A is 4 and 3D. 3 into D is minus 3. So 4 minus 3, 3 is 9. That is minus 5. Now we are going to write that AP. So AP is 4, 1, comma, minus 2, comma, minus 3. So that's all. Have you got it, children? And next question, the question number 5. It is also very simple. See, A equal to given by minus 1.25 and D equal to minus 0.25. So the first term A equal to minus 1.25 and second term A plus D equal to, we want to add on both, it will come minus 1.25 plus minus 0.25. So on both also negative. So we need to add. And to get what will come? 0.25 plus 1.25. 1.50, no. So minus 1.50 or otherwise minus 1.5. On both also same. And next is third term I'm going to find A plus 2D. Third term is A plus 2D. So A plus 2D means the value of A is minus 1.25 plus 2D.
So it is very simple. Minus 1.25,
0.25 into 2. 22 is what will come? 50. Yeah. So like that, 0.25 into 2 minus 5.0.
Now we are going to add on both to get what will come? Minus 1.75.
Minus 1.75.
And then last, I mean third term, sorry, fourth term, a plus 3d.
Fourth term is a plus 3d.
So a plus 3d means a is minus 1.25 plus 3 into minus 0.25. So minus 1.25 minus 0.25, what will come?
253 is a, that is 0.75.
So minus 0.75.
So minus 0.75 and minus 1.25, it will come minus 2. Minus? So what is in your AP? Minus 1.25, comma minus 1.50, comma minus 1.75, comma minus 2. 0.0 or minus 2. That is your wish. Yes, student. So have I got it?
Yes.
And next, the last row I'm going to do you. It is also very simple, but we need to check the given sequence is the AP or not. So we need to check, and then only we have to find extra excess the next byte. I mean excess term. So the fourth question and example 2 are both also in your same pattern of questions. So fourth question I'm going to give you now. So for that fourth question, basically I'm giving you the simple question and by next one is some difficult question. So fourth one, the first one is very simple. 2, 4, 8, 16. It's moving. Okay. And consecutively on this, I'm giving you the question number is fourth one. Minus 10, minus 6, minus 2, plus 2, it's moving. Students, listen carefully. So what is the given question? Which of the following APs? Following of APs. If they form an AP, mean write the common difference and write three more terms. So listen, so first we have to check the given sequence is the AP or not. We need to check A2 minus A1 is equal to A3 minus A2, sometimes A4 minus A3 also. So the three times you have to check. Sum of the sequence is missed, so 2-1. Okay, so I'm taking A2 minus A1 as first. So A2, the second term is 4, minus the first term is 2. So 4 minus 2 is 2. Yes, student. And A3 minus A2, that is the third term is 8, minus second term is 4. So 8 minus 4 equal to 4. It is not equal. So see, A2 minus A1, which is not equal to A3 minus A2. So therefore, the sequence, it is not function AP. Not function AP. Suppose the sequence not function AP, we can't find the next three more terms. No. So that's all. And third question, fourth question, I'm giving you minus 10, minus 6, minus 2, plus 2. Yes? Now I'm taking A2 minus A1, which is equal to A2. The second term is minus 6, minus of minus 10. So you know very well, otherwise write a single step, minus 6 plus 10, which is equal to plus 1. Otherwise you need one more step, right? Not a problem. And A3 minus A2, which is equal to A3 is minus 2. So minus into minus plus 6. So minus 2 plus 6, that's also 4. And both also same. Suppose for the 100% checking, we are going to take A4 minus A3 also. A4 is what is that? 2 minus of minus plus 2, which is equal to 4. So all the one become equal. Okay. So what we have concluded? A2 minus A1 equal to A3 minus A2 equal to A4 minus A3. Okay, so it is forms and AP. Forms and AP. Yes, student, have you got it?
Yes, fine.
And next one, what are you asking the question? Write the three more terms. So how many terms are they are given? First, second, third, fourth terms, four terms are given. Now I'm going to write fifth term, A5. You know what is the fifth term? A plus, what is that? OD. Okay, because this is A, that is A plus D, A plus 2D, A plus 3D. So the fifth term, it will come A plus 4D. So the value of A is, what is that A? Minus 10.
plus 4 into what is that b? 4 and 4 are 16. So minus 10 plus 16, it will come 6. Okay? And 6th term, a6 which is equal to a plus 5b. A plus 5b. So for that, a is minus 10 plus 5 into d. 5 4 are. What is that? 20. So what will come? 20 minus 10 which is equal to 10. So like that, we need to find the 7th term also. What is the 7th term? A plus 6b. So the value of a is minus 10 and 6 into d, the value of d. What is the d? D equal to 4. You should mention. Okay, d equal to 4. So 6 4s are 24. So 24 minus 10 is equal to 14. So like that, you have to find that and the consecutive terms of AP. Have you got it, children? Yes. And by this moment, I am giving you some different question I am going to teach you now. Okay. And the remaining, try it yourself in your homework. Yes, student. So next question, in your Roman, fourth Roman. Irrational number, I give you one question, I give you. And next, so the fraction also you know very well. So I'm giving you some different question based on which one? 12th and 13th are both of the same manner, it is in the irrational format. So I'm giving you 12th question. So the correct one is root 2 comma, root 8 comma, root 18 comma, root 32 comma, and so going on. And next I'm giving you some different question based on what is that? 10th and 11th. So 11th question I'm giving you. So 11th question for you, a comma, a square comma, a cube comma, a power 4. So student, it is very simple for this question. And before that, root 2. It is the simplest form, so it is no problem. So write the same. But root 8, you have a simplest form of root 8 is 4 2s are 8. So 4 is the square root of 2. So how to write this? 2 root 2. 2 root 2. Then 18. 18 is 9 2 is 18. So 9 is the square root of 3. So 3 root 2. Then root 32 is 16. 2 is 32. 16 is the square root of 4. So 4 root 2. And so moving on. So finally we have decided the simplest form of the irrational number. It is from the sequence. Now we need to check A2 minus A1. A2 is root 2 root 2. And A1 is root 2. So we know 2 root 2 minus 1 root 2 to get 1 root 2. Yes, student. Do you know the subtraction of the irrational number? Already you studied in your 9th syllabus, no?
Yeah.
Then A3 minus A2. So the value of A3, third term is 3 root 2 minus 2 root 2. So 3 root 2 minus 2 root 2, it will come 1 root 2. So it is moving on like that. So by that, A2 minus A1 equal to A3 minus A2. So the given sequence, it is forms and AP. Forms and AP. Good student. Next one we are going to do. Next 3 more terms we are going to find. So 3 more terms mean first, second, third, fourth term. So again the same 5th term. A5 equal to A plus 4B. So the value of A is root 2. And then the value of B is root 2. So A, 4B means 4 root 2. So root 2 plus 4 root 2, it will come 5 root 2. 5 root 2. And then consecutively, A is equal to A plus 5B. So A is root 2 plus 5B means 5 root 2, which is equal to 6 root 2. And then finally, A7 equal to A plus 6D. So root 2 plus 6 root 2, which is equal to 7 root 2. So finally, you have to write the next 3 terms are, what are they? 5 2 comma, 6 2 2 comma, 7 2. Have you got it, children? I hope you all, these are very simple, you know?
Yes.
And 11th question. It is some different because of the exponents are given. A comma, A square comma, A cube comma, A 4. Yes? Now, I am taking A 2 minus A 1 which is equal to A square minus A. So, we can't subtract the exponent. So, I am taking common outside A, it will come A minus 1 because A square and that A. So you have a common term A. If you want to take outside, it will come A into A minus 1. And the next, A3 minus A2. Yes, A3 is A cube minus A2 is A square. Do you have any common term? Yes, I have a common term of A square. So A square is going to take outside the remaining A minus 1. So compare this to A2 minus A1, which is not equal to A3 minus A2. So therefore, it is not forms an AP. It is not an AP. Not forms an AP, or it is not an AP. So that's all. Have you got it, children?
Yes.
Then the last question I am giving you, based on this pattern, some different, like square numbers. Okay. See, students, the fifth questions are some different 0.2, 0.22, 0.222 and moving on. So definitely it will not form an AP. Why? Because of the first term, the decimal place is 1, the second term of decimal place is 2, third term of decimal place is 3. So it will not form an AP. So check your answer. And next, the eighth term, eighth question, see, listen, -1/2, -1/2, -1/2. So that is also very simple. Why? Because of already I told you, for the sequence, all the terms are, it become equally. That is called a common sequence, a constant sequence. What is the name of that? Constant sequence. So the constant sequence, constant AP, it will come the same for every term. 4 terms, 7 terms, 10 terms, or every term. Okay. Then last question I am giving you, 14th one. Question number 14, the given question is 1 square, 3 square, 5 square, 7 square, it is also very simple, student. So listen, we want to take the actual sequence. 1 square is 1, 3 square is 9, 5 square is 25, and 7 square is 49. And so on. Yes? Okay. Now you have to check A2 minus A1 equal to 9 minus 1. So which is 8. Then A3 minus A2 is, what is that? 25 minus 9. So 25 minus 9 is what? 16. So from the first two, they are not equal, no. So A2 minus A1, which is not equal to A3 minus A2. So it is not from an AP. Student, have you got it?
Yes.
I hope you all enjoyed for this plan. So student, write the definition for AP and make it to complete the first exercise soon. So we'll meet the next class. Thank you, students.